That's it, lads. Let's see them stones standing tall by the end of the day. Careful there, careful. I'm not losing three of you in one week. Oh, my castle. My castle stands. Dearest Margaret, I do wish you would come see what myself and my army of workmen are achieving here on the tour. For where once there was but wood and wilderness, and then a broken mess of quarried stone, now there begins to be the semblance of a home. A castle, I've called it, and it shall, be sure, stand strong as any castle, keeping safe the lives within. But the life therein shall be the life of no great conqueror, merely that of a man who's done his world some good, earned a little rest for his wearied bones, and who would have the woman he took so long ago for his wife at his side once more. Come, Margaret, this very night I shall send my carriage. Walk with me in this hollow shell. You and I will yet fill with warmth and colour and life, with mutual solace in the years left us before we're gone and only our castle is left. Your devoted husband, Richard. Margaret? Are you there? I was over at the Masson Mill. The problem... Well, never mind. I came swift as I could. Margaret? Wretched owls. When there's a roof on this place, you shan't have the free run of it. Nests on the scaffolding, shit on the walls, blooded mice on the floor. The castle's mine, you bloody ugly birds, not yours. My home. And I will not be...
My home. My home.
What? Who's that? Is that you, Margaret?
My home, and I will not be. Will Who? Not be. Will not.
What? What?
Richard.
Who? Jess? Jessie?
Richard.
What are you doing here?
I had to...
Your head, it's bleeding.
One of those birds, owls, flapped at me. Out there in the night, I thought it was...
Look, here, the slab. Here, sit down.
Crooker.
What?
I thought it was.
Oh,
for a moment.
You've been listening to old stories, Jess. Old stories or your old man.
Abel. Yes. I've been listening to Abel. I listen to machines in that mill all day, then go home and listen to him huddled in his chimney corner, churning out the same rubbish he spouted since the day you dragged him from that hole in the ground.
You say yourself it's rubbish.
It can't all be rubbish. There were caves here, weren't there? Right where we're sitting now, and bones in them.
And all that's gone now. Look what I've put in its place.
Another cave.
A castle, a home. Look. Well, add a roof, windows, doors, furnishings, and then it will be.
Until then, what is it but the bones of a house?
Yet, once again, it's these bones of mine you run to for shelter, Jess.
Yes.
Why?
What have I got elsewhere but a fist in my face?
What?
You think it was that bird flapping up, black of my eye, got it bleeding. It was him, Abel.
Again.
Again and again. You don't know what he's like, what he's become. Like a ragged dog, the world's beat into a corner, and in that corner, God forbid you should try and touch it. Ever since that day, he's been convinced there's something creeping close. Crooker, for want of a better name, angry at him breaking into his holy of holies.
Holy? Some cave where ancient savages murdered children. And for what? A god that didn't exist. What better service could be done Christian civilization than to wipe it away like it was never here?
A man who runs mills from here to Scotland oughtn't, perhaps, to cast the first stone where burying children in the dark's concerned.
What? Is that something he put you up to saying?
It's something years of graft in their mills put me up to saying. Them dark pits where the life in us all gets sacrificed to... What? Some other god no one will believe in another 1,000 years or two?
You've done all right out of the sacrifices I've demanded. The whole Derwent Valley has. Good, honest work for good, honest pay. An alehouse, homes that aren't hovels, a Sunday school, a place in the modern world where before there was what? We're not heathens here nowadays.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.